Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Good Morning Bay Street for Tuesday, April 17th, 2012. At 6:30 a.m. on the East Coast, we do have stock index futures and commodities slightly above fair value, so we are looking for a higher open Tuesday morning at 9:30. No major trend changes on Monday. The TSX still on a sell signal. The VIX still on a buy signal. No change for the S&P 500. And we saw a lot of weakness in technology stocks. Both Apple and Google were sharply lower yesterday, and that would put downward pressure on the NASDAQ 100. We still saw money flow into the bond market. Bonds were up yesterday. No change for the US dollar, no change for the euro, and no change for the Canadian dollar on Monday. Taking a look at commodities, starting with crude oil, if you look at the bottom of the screen, you'll see three pressure zones that went off. And you'll see that back here, it certainly didn't take a lot to move the market higher. A little more pressure here to move the market higher. And then over here, we've developed a lot of downward pressure, but still have not been able to move the market higher. So that's probably not a good sign for the price of crude oil. Over here, you can see the bottom of the panic zones are down just above $95. That could be a potential target to the downside. We're still being held in place by the flypaper channel, so stuck in the flypaper channel right now. That's a good area to find support, so that's certainly a positive for the bulls. The moving averages are still holding the price of crude oil, so that's a positive for the bulls. We've got an uptrend line and a downtrend line. A break of those lines should tell us which way we're going to go next. We're trading above 100 right now, and certainly the $100 level is a major area of psychological and mathematical support. If we do break down, we saw $95 at the bottom of the panic zone chart. 93.75 is our mathematical target, and so a move down to that range would not be unexpected if we do break down here. The pros, while we've been trading sideways and above $100, it does not look like the pros want to take control right now. We would get a confirmed buy signal with a daily close above a 103.92 on Tuesday. Taking a look at gasoline has a nice open gap that's acting as support right now and holding the price of gas up. We are currently on a sell signal right now, and that did not change yesterday. So if we can move lower, then the bottom of the open gap would be our next area of potential support for the price of gasoline. Looking at heating oil, no change on Monday, and looking at natural gas, no change there as well. Copper moved lower yesterday and bounced off support. If support does not hold, then 343 is our next target to the downside. Looking at the price of gold, we came down to the lower channel line on Monday. A daily close below 1642.32 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday, and that would join silver, which quickly reversed its gains from last week. Let's take a walk through some of the major TSX indexes. And you're not going to see any changes here, which means we don't have any changes for the Horizon Beta Pro ETFs that we follow. We're still short the TSX. We're short energy, financial services, and gold. No change in infotech, no change in materials, no change in small caps. I'm going to start doing a small cap video, be a very short video, and just cover the a couple of the major North American small cap indexes and ETFs. The first one should be out tomorrow. No change for the venture exchange, so nothing, no buying opportunities on Tuesday morning. And last up this morning, just a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. We've got the VIX above the flypaper channel. That means we should expect weakness in the market. We could go down to the recent low, so if we break 1719, that would be bullish for the stock market. And then if we start moving above the recent high and start breaking out above 2188, that would certainly be bearish for the Canadian stock market. First sign of strength for the stock market on Tuesday is going to be an hourly close below 1939. If the VIX starts breaking down below that point, that should be supportive for higher stock prices. The TSX moved up to the flypaper channel recently, and we need to break out above 12,200 to tell us that the bulls are back in control. Notice we've been making a series of lower highs and lower lows, and that's certainly a very bearish pattern. We found resistance at the 100-hour moving average. We're trading below the 50-hour. If we break out above the 100, then the 200-hour moving average up at 12,300 would be our next area of potential resistance. First sign of strength on Tuesday is going to be an hourly close above 12,078. If we are trading above that level at 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, or 2:30, that would be an intraday buy signal for the TSX on Tuesday. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Wednesday morning.